I don't have any excuses for how darker skinned sisters get treated in America. But I know a lot of the conflicts between brothers and sisters needs to cease. We need to come together.
First off, I want to send all my love to the family, moms, pops, G-moms, Lauren, Imani Cross, Black Sam, Adam, George, B.H., Cobby, J-Stone, Jay, J-Rock, you know what I'm saying, the whole family already know what it is with me. Nip, you feel me, that's my brother from the other color, you know what I'm saying? He was like a real big brother to me. Like every time I'm with Nipsey, we not talking about nothing that don't mean nothing. We always talking about goals, family, homies, plays we trying to make. Like I was having conversations with Nip about, I'm like, look, bro, we got some light-skinned, pretty girls we got to raise. We in trouble, what we going to do? You know what I'm saying? And bro always gave me advice. You feel me? This loped out crip, he gave me books to read and shit like that. I'm like, this is different, man. You know what I'm saying? I could talk about a lot, but bro fought for me, I fought for him. You feel me? I look at bro like a real big brother. He sent me a text message on my birthday, March 9th. He texted me like, happy birthday, bro. I want to congratulate you for building a brand that's going to last forever. Respect. And I replied like, good looking, bro. I told bro, I said, hustle the motivation, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? So, I just want to let bro know, I want to congratulate bro for his legacy and everything he did. All the game he gave me, all the people he touched, and for the brand he left behind. On the behalf of the West Coast, on the behalf of LA, the streets, my, we love you, my, I'm gonna miss you, my, and you already know what it is. All money in 400 on mines. And like Lauren said, the motherfucking marathon continues.
Jumbo, jumbo, shalom, shalom. I do hope the tribe is well. Hope you're safe. I appreciate your viewership, whatever time you happen to be listening to this. Before I start, always praises to the Most High. Now, I have seen a few videos that sisters done on here about the YG speech on Nip Hustle's memorial, funeral, whatever you want to call it. And I got to say, the things that YG was saying was very unnecessary. We don't need comments like that ever in general. We don't need them. Because we have so many other conflicts in this community that we're dealing with, that we just don't need that. That wasn't the setting for a comment like that, and it never will be. We were there to honor Nip, the great, as a human, as an artist, as a father. Everything he's done for my community. I don't understand where your child's skin tone comes into play. Like, we're talking about Nip, and YG brings up skin tone out of nowhere. I don't even know what that had to do with the memorial. But there's a but. I've seen a few videos that I was just like, what the hell is this? Like I seen sisters saying he's fetishizing or sexualizing. That one got me. Some sisters say he's sexualizing his daughter. I'm like, I don't get where you're getting at. He's ignorant as hell. He's a lot of things, but sexualizing his daughter? I didn't get that. That's not what I got from what I heard from YG. Plus, we never talk about the swirling mammies. We never talk about how they seek a Brad for the hair, the eyes, the good hair, the skin. The conflicts go both ways. There are brothers with self-hate, and there are sisters with self-hate. My thing is, why is it we can't support brothers and sisters that got love for us, that appreciate us? No matter if you yellow, you brown, you red, you black, why can't we support brothers and sisters like that? I got love for my women. I appreciate my women. I appreciate my brothers that appreciate their women. Why can't we ever support that? Why are we always so focused on rappers and entertainers? That's where a lot of the conflicts come from. I can never put this much energy into all this negative shit on YouTube. All these rappers and entertainers, I don't know how y'all do it. And then y'all talking about how he talks, the N-word. That's how we talk out here in the West. 95% of your conscious people use the N-word. I don't use the N-word myself, but that's just how we talk out here. But yeah, I just wanted to get my take on. Y'all be safe out there. Shalom. Y'all be good. Thank you for listening.